What's happening, guys? Keith here with your July 8th edition of the Impact Report. So if you haven't checked out my review already from this past week's episode of Impact, you can do so by clicking the link at the top of the screen. And speaking of this past week's episode of Impact, it drew 304,000 viewers. This is up 50,000 from last week, which did 254,000 viewers. And ranked 96 on Cable's Top 150. That 96 is pretty impressive. Earlier this year, when Impact drew its highest viewership at 399,000, they still ranked over 100 at 116. This is the first time in a while that Impact were in the top 100, so good stuff there. And we head over to Impact Wrestling's YouTube page to look at the top three viewed highlights from this past week's episode of Impact. And number three is Soo Young and the Undead Bridesmaid versus Madison Rayne and Allie. This had 85,000 views. Number two, Sami Callihan disguises himself as Pentagon Jr. This did 153,000 views. And far and away, number one, Homicide and Hernandez return to lay waste to LAX. And this had 315,000 views, so double of number two. Definitely the right way to end Impact this past week. But interesting to note that Soo Young and Madison Rayne and Sami Callihan and Pentagon Jr. were both holding strong as they were in the top three last week. So it seems like they are onto something there. So earlier this week, or I should say last week, Impact Wrestling has announced that starting this Tuesday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Joe Hendry will be taking over their Twitch channel to bring you prestigious Tuesdays with Joe Hendry. They will have live Q&A and guests from the Impact roster. I believe Monday also debuts the show of Sanjay Dutt and Josh Matthews. I'm not sure of the name. I know it popped up on this past week's episode of Impact, but nothing on their Twitter page, their Twitch page. So if you guys know the details on that, I'd appreciate if you left that in the comment section below. And we apparently have news that Impact Wrestling will be coming to Las Vegas in November. This past Thursday, the owner of Future Stars of Wrestling, Joe DeFalco, posted on Facebook, "It's time to let the cat out of the bag. The deal is finalized to bring Impact Wrestling to Las Vegas. Clear your calendars for 3 days in November. More details regarding pricing, VIPs, meet and greets, seminars, and more coming soon." And on Friday, the Future Stars of Wrestling's Facebook page posted, "We have finalized an agreement to bring Impact Wrestling to Sam's Town. Sunday, November 11th through Tuesday, November 13th for three big nights of tapings featuring FSW alumni Eli Drake, Killer Cross, Johnny Impact, Taya, and Brian Cage, along with their star-studded roster. Ticket packages, VIPs, and meet and greets are being put together for the event. We look forward to working with the crew at Impact to make this a can't-miss event." So there seems to be speculation that the Sunday show on November 11th could be Bound for Glory. No official word on that yet, but I will keep everyone updated if that news hits. So on the 4th of July edition of the Impact Report, I spoke about Sami Callihan calling out Ring of Honor about no one wanting to get in the ring with him on the Chris Jericho cruise. Well, his challenge was accepted by the villain Marty Scurll. Chris Jericho posted a video confirming it and saying that for the first time ever on the Chris Jericho cruise, it's Ring of Honor versus Impact Wrestling. And the first match is Sami Callihan versus Marty Scurll. This is going to be a great match. I'm a fan of both of these men, and I think they match up well together. So hopefully we get some sort of video of this, maybe possibly airing on an episode of Impact. But I guess we will see what happens more as far as Impact versus Ring of Honor. Who knows? Maybe they can make this some sort of live Twitch show coming from the cruise itself. That would be amazing. But like I said, we will see how that goes. The Daily DDT has released an article titled "The Rated R Superstars of Impact Wrestling." Here's just a little snippet of the article. It says, on a daily basis, it's challenging to navigate the wrestling Twitterverse without someone bemoaning the lost happenings of WWE's Attitude Era. A time when blood flowed freely, envelope-pushing storylines were the norm, and the best-selling merch was adorned with curse words and middle fingers. The Impact Wrestling of today is not the Attitude Era, but it may have taken a few pointers from the most successful boom period in the history of sports entertainment. Impact has matured. After years of creative uncertainty, accusations of being WWE light knockoff, a retirement home for the future endeavored, creative direction has pointed its finger at the 18 to 30 demographic. Impact is the Quentin Tarantino movie to Vince McMahon's Disney Empire, and I cannot applaud them enough for this gutsy move. So I'm going to pin the link to the article down in the comments section for you guys to check out. It's definitely worth a read, and I think we've all seen this move by Impact to moving toward a more mature audience on the last couple weeks of Impact, especially this week. And I've heard that nothing but good things out of the next two episodes that are going to air before Slammiversary, so that's great to hear. And last but not least, last night we had the Rise of the Knockouts Twitch special. Unfortunately, due to technical difficulties, the first two matches were not streamed live. However, the rest of the show was, and it was very enjoyable. I'm not going to give anything away in case you guys missed it, but definitely notable things were the Falls Count Anywhere match for the Knockouts title. That was ridiculous with Soraya Knight versus Soo Young. And the main event, which was originally supposed to be a 30-minute Iron Woman match between Shotzi Blackheart and Delilah Doom for the Phoenix of Rise Championship, both women had actually sustained injuries prior to the show, so they were both unable to compete. However, we did still get that 30-minute Iron Woman match for the now-vacated Phoenix of Rise Championship, but this time with different competitors, and it did not disappoint. Very good main event. I would definitely recommend checking this show out. There were some other good matches on the card as well, but these two stood out to me. So that is really all I have for you guys this weekend. There was no media teleconference, probably because of July 4th. So I will catch you guys next time for my Impact review. And until then, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.